we need videos. We needed to publish videos. So we need someone to do this. This someone was me.
Raed Fares was a real estate salesman in the small town of Kanfranbel, 30 miles south of the Turkish border, when Syria's uprising began in March 2011. A month later, he became a full-time activist. He decided to create a banner, the first of many that would tell the story of Kanfranbel, and to film the banners and protests.
No free media, no freelance media from other countries and the region. The region media was so bad in doing this and didn't do anything to show what was going here in Kanfranbel or anywhere in Syria.
Fares came face to face with the conflict when the Syrian army invaded Kanfranbel. His videos began to take on a whole new meaning.
On 4 July 2011, the Syrian army occupied Kanfranbel, came inside Kanfranbel. So the videos in July and after, in July 2011, and after, it was about the Syrian army in the city.
With Syrian troops in his hometown, Fares and his friends found themselves in a cat-and-mouse situation with the authorities.
We came inside Kanfranbel, do our demonstration like 15 minutes and run away outside Kanfranbel.
As the conflict escalated, so did Fares' determination. He created new banners each week and made sure the world knew where they were from. Fast forward to 2013. Kanfranbel is still being shelled by Syrian troops, and Fares is still getting out the word with banners in English and Arabic. Recently, he had a different message, creating a banner for the people of Boston after the bombings. The image was shared 15,000 times on his Facebook page and went viral.
The people in Boston, they need some support from the Middle East. Just wanted to say that, and just the people in Boston just do accept our condolences. That's why.
But after more than 2 years of documenting the Syrian conflict, Fares still does not see himself as a journalist.
I'm an activist. I'm serving my revolution. I'm serving my agenda revolution. I'm not doing this to be journalist, and I don't have any dreams to be journalist. I'm just an activist.
According to the United Nations, there are more than 1.2 million Syrian refugees worldwide. But Fares says he wants to remain in his country to continue reporting and documenting what he sees as the truth. Mohammed Alhamoui is reluctant to talk about his confinement by the Syrian regime. It all started when Alhamoui decided to take part in the Syrian revolution. Along with his friends, he began to film the demonstrations.
Revolution starts, I stopped everything. We decided with the other friends to participate in the revolution and go demonstrate in Daraya.
Before the conflict, Alhamoui was a student and a computer repair technician, a skill that became useful.
Responsible for the uploading for the videos we film in the demonstrations. My friends used to film video. I used to go bring the videos and upload them.
But soon Alhamoui and his friends would pay a price for daring to aim the video cameras at the Assad regime. The army killed one of his friends. Another was detained and is still being held. Alhamoui was also arrested.
I was filming the airport, military airport, from my home roof. They discovered that and they came and detained me with my friends and my father.
After the harrowing experience, Alhamoui fled to Jordan. From there, he continues to monitor the war in Syria. He underscored the role of video.
It was important to let the people see what's the regime doing. And you can't let them know without video. If you write about it, they can imagine a little. But if you filmed about it, they can imagine the right picture.
According to the Committee to Protect Journalists, 2012 marked the most dangerous year for journalists worldwide, with Syria leading the way. Despite the danger, activists like Arhamwi and Fares continue to rebel against the Assad regime through their videos, which have become the face of the revolution. Allah ya Rasul, kita bersama kita ya Allah.